past several years, there's been hundreds of child labor violations here, including a 195.8 increase between 2000 and 2022. Adding this bill here, do you think that would increase that and the child would be taken advantage of?
First of all, this bill is not about children. This bill is about 16 and 17 year olds. These are youth workers.
Don't call them children, folks. Those are youth workers. Yesterday, the Florida legislature held a hearing on a bill that we previously covered on the show that would kneecap child labor protections in the state. And you're not going to be surprised to find out who's really behind that bill. Of course, it's not the young children who are just so excited about the idea of being exploited. Oh, I'm sorry, did I call them children? I should have said their proper term, youth workers, which Representative Linda Chaney, who's the woman you heard from at the top of the story, she herself actually had a hard time keeping those two terms straight. And it ended up being very embarrassing for her. So check this out.
There is also with school choice, there's a lot of differences in children in youth schedules now.
Oh, don't you just love that? Now, the phrase youth workers appears to come from the Foundation for Government Accountability, or the FGA, which is a lobbying group with ties to several conservative supervillains. So some on the FGA from Washington Post. The FGA is funded by a broad swath of ultra-conservative and Republican donors, such as the Ed Yulin Family Foundation and 85 Fund, a nonprofit connected to political operative Leonard Leo, who have similarly supported other conservative policy groups. Now, Cheney and the FGA have a strong relationship, to say the least, as More Perfect Union reported on previously. Attached is draft language on the youth worker freedom. I can't say youth worker freedom without laughing a little bit. Youth worker freedom issue that Representative Cheney expressed interest in to FGA, a lobbyist for the FGA's advocacy arm, wrote in an August 28th email to an aide to Representative Linda Cheney, Republican legislator from St. Pete Beach. 3 weeks later, Cheney filed House Bill 49. A nearly verbatim copy of the FGA's proposal, because as we all know, these members of Congress, state legislators, they don't all write the legislation they propose. In fact, that's the job of their wealthy donors and the lobbyists to write that legislation, to write those bills, pass it off to the politicians who they have in their pockets, and then have those politicians present those pieces of legislation like the good puppets that they are. Of course, I laughed earlier about the use of the phrase youth worker freedom. That's language that comes directly from the FGA. But what exactly is in this bill? So under current Florida state law, there's a list of things 17 and 16 year olds can't do in the workplace. Let me read those off for you. They can't work between 11 p.m. and 6:30 a.m. on a school night. Reasonable. Where they can't work more than 8 hours if they have school the next day. Perfectly reasonable. They cannot work more than 30 hours during a school week or more than 6 days in a row at any time of the year. Fantastic protections to ensure that children aren't having to sacrifice their education for employment. But not only would House Bill 49 remove every single one of those protections, it would also prevent local communities from passing any stronger child labor protections, much like the Texas Death Star bill. Again, because Florida, the state that really cares about children, they just want to protect the children, which is why we're going to repeal every single protection we have for them under our labor laws. Now, we're bringing this story back up because several amendments to that bill were proposed and every single one of them was voted down. So I'm going to read off to you what those amendments to this bill were. The first one would have allowed parents of child laborers to enter unannounced to inspect the employer. Next one would have required employers to provide training materials to parents. Then requiring employers to maintain sexual harassment records and give copies to parents. Requiring employers to notify parents if their child witnesses an act of violence at work. allowing legally employed 16 and 17 year olds to get an abortion without parental consent, as the bill says they don't need parental consent to work. Love that one. Creating a Department of Labor to protect all workers, including kids, against wage theft and other labor violations. And finally, preventing minors from obtaining work learning credits unless the worksite is OSHA certified and has a proven history of safety. I have to especially highlight the one about the Department of Labor, because yes, Florida has no Department of Labor. It was dissolved in 2002, and not because all workplace violations were non-existent at that point and they felt they didn't need it anymore. That was definitely not the reason why they dissolved the Department of Labor in the state of Florida. Now, I just want to drive this point home and how dangerous this bill is. So here's some testimony from an 18-year-old who started working at age 15 and his concerns about this bill.
I'm 18 years old. I started working at 15, so I understand the struggle that he's describing, but it's very important to have these laws in place. We do not want minors who are going to high school working 12 a.m. to 6 a.m. How are they going to function at school? I know people who did that, working under the table. And they did not succeed in high school. You cannot succeed in high school if you are going from straight from work to school. I did not know as a minor how to report workplace violations. Minors don't know how to do that. They don't know the law. You say get informed, they're not gonna get informed. They have more important things. They got school, work, having make time for friends. They're not gonna care about reading some legal document to understand how the law works. So yes, we have these laws, but they don't matter if they can't be enforced.
And he's right. I got my first job when I was 15. I didn't know what my protections were. I wouldn't have known that if my manager hadn't said, hey, you can't work more than 40 hours a week, or hey, you can't work more than 8 hours a day. If you get close to that number, you have to clock out. And the only reason my manager told me those things was so he didn't get in trouble, because it's Illinois state law, because we actually care about protecting the children of the state of Illinois. But Cenk, I just can't get past the hypocrisy that this is the same Florida state legislator that passed the Parents' Bill of Rights, but they're like, parents should have no rights when it comes to child employment. This is the state legislator that emphasized how deeply they care about protecting the children, but they don't care about protecting the children from labor violations or, you know, protecting their education. They want them to sacrifice that so that they can make less than minimum wage and help the businesses and help the corporations and the right wing interests in the state.
So let's talk about the two hypocrisies and then the two giant points in the story. One is the one that you point out, oh my God, parents have to have rights. And then, or you're like, okay, great, let's give parents rights so they know what abuses their kids might be going through at work. No, as long as it helps corporations. Number two, did you notice the one they voted down? Requiring employers to maintain sexual harassment records and give copies to parents. Remember, this is the same Florida. It's like, oh, you gotta ban gay people, talk about gay people or trans, etc., because of groomers. Oh, there's groomers that are at big businesses? Oh, that's totally fine. Don't report it to the parents. Our beloved corporations, we serve you. You are our masters, right? To that point, look at this Orwellian language. They changed the state tax to death tax. They changed torture to enhanced interrogation. And now child labor has become youth worker freedom. It's a joke. And finally, this story is like a political CSI scene. So that you see the billionaires fund the think tanks write the bills, hand it to the legislators hand it in verbatim. And by the way, another part of the story, the legislators are then asked about it because they didn't even read the goddamn thing. They don't care. They just took the money from the donors, they cashed their checks and they hand in the bill. So when they get in trouble for it, they go back to the think tank and says, what's the billionaires marketing here to help me turn this child abuse of children into youth worker freedom? And then the think tank gives them the memo back, hey, dumb, say this and here's your next check, dummy. And then the state legislators of Florida are like, okay, right, don't protect the children, screw the children. If they get sexually harassed, don't tell their parents, because we're for youth worker freedom. Yeah, that's what I thought, Florida Republicans. You never meant a word of it. All you do is serve your corporate donors.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member, and members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence, and that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.